Hello, BookTube. I thought today that we'd continue on with the second bookshelf, the one that's mostly suspense and thriller novels. We'll start at the third shelf, finish it up. That's only a couple books, and then go down into the fourth shelf. There's only five shelves total. On the fourth shelf, we'll do a few novels, and then we'll make a second video for the remainder of that shelf, because it's all John Le Carré novels, and they might as well just be one video. So we'll start here with Devil May Care, the new James Bond novel. Sebastian Fox writing as Ian Fleming. Well, he's not really. They're telling you right off the bat that it's Sebastian Fox. Sebastian Fox's seven previous novels include the international bestseller Birdsong, Charlotte Gray, and most recently Angleby, which was in 2007. He lives in London, is married, and has two sons and a daughter. Very nice. This is a 2008 book. The copyright's held by Ian Fleming Publications. So right here we have a nice little map to help you out with the story. Shows the region of the USSR, Iran, a little section of Afghanistan, Iraq, Turkey. Caspian Sea is dead smack in the middle of the map. So Devil May Care is a masterful continuation of the James Bond legacy, an electrifying new chapter in the life of the most iconic spy of literature and film, written to celebrate the centenary of Ian Fleming's birth on May 28, 1908. An Algerian drug runner is savagely executed in the desolate outskirts of Paris. This seemingly isolated event leads to the recall of Agent 007 from his sabbatical in Rome and his return to the world of intrigue and danger, where he is most at home. The head of MI6, M, assigns him to shadow the mysterious Dr. Julius Garner, a power-crazed pharmaceutical magnate whose wealth is exceeded only by his greed. Garner has lately taken a disquieting interest in opiate derivatives, both legal and illegal, and this urgently bears looking into. So, Devil May Care, and the publisher on this, was Doubleday. So the next one here, let me throw this down there. The Righteous Men, The End of the World is Coming, One Body at a Time, by Sam Bourne. There's Sam Bourne there. Sam Bourne is a pseudonym for the award-winning journalist and broadcaster Jonathan Friedland. He writes weekly columns in both The Guardian and the London Evening Standard, as well as a monthly piece for the Jewish Chronicle. He also presents BBC Radio 4's contemporary history series, The Long View. The author of Jacob's Gift and Bring Home the Revolution, Friedland, named by the Financial Times as one of the world's most influential commentators, lives in London. This is a HarperCollins book. It was published in 2006. A teenage computer prodigy is mortally strangled in Mumbai. A far-right extremist is killed in a remote cabin in the Pacific Northwest. A wealthy businessman is murdered in Thailand. A pimp in Brooklyn is found stabbed to death and mysteriously covered by a brown shroud. What connects the victims is an ancient prophecy that will lead to the end of the world, and it's up to Will Monroe, a fledgling reporter in the New York Times, to stop it. Next, we'll move on to three of the Steve Barry historical thrillers, I guess is what you'd call them. They're a lot in the tradition of Dan Brown. They're pretty successful. well done. I like him. I like Dan Brown. Not everybody. Well, let's face it, a good portion of the world did, but you don't always hear the greatest reviews or read the greatest reviews. But as entertainment, I liked it. So, Steve Barry is the New York Times bestselling author of The Third Secret, The Romanov Prophecy, and The Amber Room. His books have been translated into 29 languages. A lawyer who has traveled extensively throughout the Caribbean, Mexico, Europe, and Russia, he lives on the Georgia coast. Georgia, U.S., I'm assuming. He is currently at work on his next novel. All right. Well, I think he's written quite a few since this one came out. So, Templar Legacy, a novel, Steve Barry, Valentine Books, New York, 2006. This is the first edition. Historically, I'm not a big Templar guy. I mean, the actual history, a lot's been made of it with some of these conspiracy-type histories, but for fiction, it can be fun. The Ancient Order of the Knights, Templar, possessed untold wealth and absolute power over kings and popes. Until the Inquisition, when they were wiped from the face of the earth, their hidden riches lost. But now two forces vying for the treasure have learned that is not all what they thought it was, and its true nature could change the modern world. Cotton Malone, one-time top operative for the U.S. Justice Department, is enjoying his quiet new life as an antiquarian book dealer in Copenhagen when an unexpected call to action reawakens his hair-trigger instincts and plunges him back into the cloak-and-dagger world he thought he'd left behind. And Cotton Malone is his series hero. And next, Steve Barry here, also a Ballantine book. Let's see, and this one was published in 2007 as The Alexandria Link. Cotton Malone retired from the high-risk world of lead operatives for the U.S. State Department to lead the low-key life of a rare book dealer. But his quiet existence is shattered when he receives an anonymous email. You have something I want. You're the only person on earth who knows where to find it. Go get it. You have 72 hours. If I don't hear from you, you will be childless. His horrified ex-wife confirms that the threat is real. Their teenage son has been kidnapped. When Malone's Copenhagen bookshop is burned to the ground, it becomes clear that those responsible will stop at nothing to get what they want. And what they want is nothing less than the Lost Library of Alexandria. Pretty cool. And then the last one I have of his, and like I say, he's written a lot. I probably should catch up on him. So it's Ballantine Books, 2008, The Charlemagne Pursuit, and papers, nice little map. As a child, former Justice Department agent Cotton Malone was told his father died in a submarine disaster in the North Atlantic. But now he wants the full story and asks his ex-boss, Stephanie Nell, to secure the military files. What he learns stuns him. His father's sub was a secret nuclear vessel lost on a highly classified mission beneath the ice shelves of Antarctica. But Malone isn't the only one after the truth. Twin sisters Dorothy Lindauer and Crystal Falk are fighting for the fortune their mother has promised to whichever one of them discovers what really became of their father, who died on the same submarine that Malone's father captained. So, Steve Barry, The Charlemagne Pursuit. And the last two books here actually contain more than two novels. We have one of these Octopus Heinemann books. It contains a pile of novels, in this case by Robert Ludlum of Bourne fame. Yeah, this one contains The Scarlatti Inheritance, The Osterman Weekend, The Matlock Paper, and The Gemini Contenders. Those of you who like the Matt Damon, Jason Bourne movies, those are Robert Ludlum stories. I enjoy the movies and the books. So here we go. Robert Ludlum's, and I just listed the book, so. This, Scarlatti Inheritance was published in 71, The Osterman Weekend in 72, The Matlock Paper in 73, and The Gemini Contenders in 76. Heinemann and Octopus Books have put them all together in this edition, which was done in 1981. So with the Scarlatti Inheritance, the truth about Ulster Stuart Scarlatti, unpleasant, unpopular, but too successful to be ignored, is on file. A file of dynamite that spans the politics and powers of two world wars. The Osterman Weekend. Three families relax on a sunny Sunday in Saddle Valley when the attentions of a patrol car mark the beginnings of a murderous conspiracy when inexorably enveloped them all. The Matlock Paper spells violence and terror for the professor at Connecticut's Carlisle University. He is being used by the government as the key to breaking a national conspiracy centered on his own prestigious campus. The Gemini Contenders. Italy, December 1939. A specially commandeered freight train is loaded at night by priests with a cargo of ancient papers, so dangerous in content that those who travel with them die on orders by their own hand. Now, that last one, Gemini Contenders, is probably the one I enjoyed the most. And then to wrap up this part of the book tour, bookshelf tour, Robert Ludlum's The Bourne Objective, a new Jason Bourne novel by Eric von Lustbader. So, Lustbader has taken over the character and done quite a few novels. I'm not sure, let me see if there's an idea. This one was published in 2010. I know he's done some since. So at this point, Lustbader had added to Robert Ludlum's series with Bourne Deception, Bourne Sanction, Bourne Betrayal, and Bourne Legacy. Van Lustbader, he's done other things I like. I don't have any of them. I remember the Maiko, the Ninja, White Ninja. So I've always enjoyed both men's writing. So this was 2010. It was the Hatchet Book Group. Let's see if they have a picture. Yeah, they have a picture of both authors. Well, you can see it in this light. It's a rather dark and dismal day outside, but facing down mercenaries in Africa, Jason Bourne witnessed the death of an art dealer named Tracy Atherton. Her killing dredges up snatches of Bourne's impaired memory, and particularly the murder of a young woman in Bali who entrusted him with a strangely engraved ring, an artifact of such powerful significance that people have killed to obtain it. Now he's determined to find the ring's owner and purpose, but Bourne never knows what terrible acts he'll discover he committed when he digs into the past. So, newer Bourne novel. So that's it. That gets us halfway through the fourth shelf, and then after that we'll have one more shelf. The next video will be all John Le Carré. There's quite a bit of them, and they finish out the fourth shelf. So, thank you, BookTube.